Good morning. So in this video, I'm going to discuss ANOVA or analysis of variance. So ANOVA is used if you have three or more treatment. Ano? So if you have one, syempre, if you have two treatments, you're going to use t-test or z-test. So if you have three or more treatment, you need to use ANOVA to tell whether there are significant differences, ano, between your treatments. So let me share the PowerPoint. Okay, so ANOVA stands for analysis of variance. Ano? So we're going to calculate the sum of square or the variances within the treatments and between the treatments, and then we're going to compare the variances with the standard value in the ano, no, in the F table, you know. So the value from the F table will specify the critical region. So if the calculated F value falls on the critical region, so parang ganun din sa ano, sa t-test, ano, you will have ano, significant differences between the treatment. So let's ano. Okay, so pag ANOVA, the null hypothesis is the mean of treatment 1 is equals to the mean of treatment 2, and so on, ano. So, pag ano, if we're going to reject the null hypothesis, the alternative hypothesis is at least two of the means are not equal. So, ibig sabihin, there is a significant difference between two means. Ano? So, in ANOVA, in doing the ANOVA test, you cannot really tell whether it's halimbawa, mean 1 is significantly different to mean 2. Halimbawa, you have rejected the null hypothesis. You cannot really tell whether it's mean 1 that is different to mean 2 or mean 1 is different to mean 5, ano? Significantly different to mean 5. Pero what you can conclude from the analysis of variance is there are two means, no, that are significantly different. By common sense, halimbawa, there is a significant difference. The ANOVA tells you that there's a significant difference. You just look at the ano, just look at the mean of the different treatments. And then generally the two means that have extreme values will be the significantly different. Ano? Yun nga lang, pag yung halimbawa magkalapit yung value nila, you can not use ANOVA to tell whether they are significantly different. Ano? Ganun yung ano, yung limitation ng ANOVA. So ANOVA can only tell whether any of the two means in a given set of data are different, ano? I hope you're getting that. Okay, sum of squares. So there are three different sum of squares in calculating the ANOVA table. First is the SST or the total sum of squares. So basically we find this by squaring every data or every value and then subtracting the ano, the square of the total, no, the sum, summation of x, ano, the square of the total, and then divided by the number of data. So mamaya makita niyo yung formula ng SST, ano. And then the next sum of squares is the SSA. So SSA, this is the same as between the treatments. This is the sum of square between the treatments. So in calculating this, you need to get the sum of the values for each treatment, no? And then basically you get the sum of this, you squared it and then divide it by the number of sample in that particular treatment. And then you again subtract the sum of squares, no, of the total number of values, ano, summation of x. squared divided by n, subtract that. Ano? And then the third sum of square is the error sum of square. So generally, the error sum of square is just, kasi the total sum of square is the sum of square between treatments and the error sum of square. So to calculate SSE, we just subtract SSA from SST, you know? Because SST is SSA plus SSE. So we're going to do it later, you know? Okay. So this is the working equation for SST, you know? So as you can see, to get SST, you just get the summation of the x squared, you know, of all the data. So you can use the calculator, you know? So yung statistical data, yung mode 6 sa class quiz, tapos you just enter all the data, tapos AC, tapos you just get, you know, just press operation or OPTN, you know? Tapos number 2. Yung number 2 yung mga nandoon yung sum of squares, ano? Okay. Tapos nandoon din yung summation of x. So just get the sum of square and then the summation of x, and then you also confirm n, the number of data you have inputted, ano? So it must be the same as the yung nasa table nyo, ano, yung number of samples or number of data. So you just simply divide the squared of this summation of x with n, ano, tapos subtract niyo yun dun sa sum ng squares, okay, to get the SST. Mamaya gawin natin to, dali lang naman. and then to calculate naman the SSB or SSA, basta this is the between, you know, the sum of squares between the between the treatments, no, or this is also kay ano Walpole SSA to, ano. So you just get the, you just squared, you know, the summation of x sub I, ibig sabihin per treatment, ano, just get the squared, tapos divide nyo lamang ng n sub I, kung ilan yung data sa ano, kung ilan yung data sa treatment, ano. So just get the sum, just get the sum of for each treatment. Tapos i-subtract nyo yung ano, yung summation of x squared, you know, divided by n. So that's how you calculate the sum of squared between treatments. And then finally, to get the SSE, the error, you know, sum of squares, or SSW, within the treatment, it's just the difference between SSD and SSB, you know? So, ito yung analysis of variance table, no? So, these are the sources of variation, treatments, error, and then the total. So, you put the SSA on the sum of squares right here, the value you have calculated for SSA. Then, dito yung SSE. Then, dito yung SSE, no? Tapos the degrees of freedom, syempre yung treatment minus 1, so k minus 1. Tapos yung namang degrees of freedom sa ano, sa error, it's k times parenthesis n minus 1. O kaya naman, this is just the same as yung total number of samples minus the number of treatments, no? So that's the same, di ba? Kasi parang pag ina niyan, that's n times k minus k. So that's the total number of sample minus the number of treatment. Okay, tapos what's next is you need to calculate the mean square. So to calculate the mean square, it's just SSA divided by K minus 1. Yung magkatapat, ano? SSA minus S minus 1. You will have S1 squared. Then to find S squared, it's just SSE divided by KN minus 1. K times N minus 1. So yung magkatapat din, ano? And then you just, to calculate the computed F, it's just ano, S1 squared divided by S2 squared. So ito yung value na iko-compare natin doon sa F table, ano? And then to get the ano, the F table, itong B1, this is just K minus 1, yung number of treatment minus 1. Ito 'yon, ano? This is k minus 1. Okay. Tapos yung B2 naman, this is total number of sample as n minus k. You know? This is simply n minus k. Okay? So, let's try to solve the problem. So, pag ganun din, ano? If the calculated value, this is 4.05, ano? Alpha. Remember, alpha is the first probability of first type 1 error, no? So, if the value calculated is greater than F table, no? If F calculated is greater than F table, ibig sabihin nun, there is significant difference between any, ano, no? Any mean of the treatment. So, palimba dito sa pumatak sa critical region, ganun din, ano? There will be significant difference. Ganun yung magiging conclusion. Okay? So, okay, so let's try to solve example 13.1. Test the hypothesis U1 is equals to U2 is equals to U5 at 0.05 level of significance for the data of table 13.1 on absorption of moisture by various type of cement aggregate. So we have here 30 data. So yung different type of aggregate, we have aggregate 1, aggregate 2, aggregate 3, aggregate 4, and aggregate 5. Bali, ang K natin is 5, parang 5 treatments, ano? Tapos you have the total. So yun, hindi nyo na kailangan mag-total. Ano, given na yung mga total. Gagamitin nyo to calculate for SSA or SSB, ano? Tapos ito na rin yung summation of X natin. So ipapasok na lang natin sa calculator yung mga data para makuha natin yung summation of X squared, ano? Okay, so let's start with ano, SSP. So pasok nyo lang isa-isa yung data sa calculator using mode, tapos 6, tapos yung sa number 1, ano? Yung one variable data. So pasok nyo lang to 551, 457, 450, 499. Kasi di ba ang SST is summation of x squared, ano? Tapos i-minus nyo yung ano, yung summation of x squared divided by n. So ito yung summation of x. Okay, so pasok nyo lang lahat ng data and then get summation of x squared. Ang summation of x squared after entering all your data on the calculator, you're supposed to get something like ano, 9,677,954. Ano, you're supposed to get this. 9,677,954. Ganyan lang. Okay? So to calculate SST, it's simply ano, 9,677,954 minus 16,854. Ito ano? Squared. Tapos divided by n. N is 30, di ba? 6 times 5, so that's 30. So you're supposed to get an SST value of 209,376.8. So pag may SST na tayo, ang susunod na lang nating i-calculate ay yung SSB or SSA, ano? Yung sum of squares between treatments, ano? Or yung variances niya between treatments, ano? So to calculate SSB, 'di ba? Basically ang equation lamang nun is yung sum of x sub i squared divided by n tapos plus yung sa ibang treatments, ano, so another summation of x sub i squared divided by, and this is n sub I, kung ilan yung number of ano samples in a treatment. So for example, ito, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So 6 yung n sub I. Ano? Tapos yung ma-minus nyo rin yung total sum, yung squared, nung ano, no? Nung, yung sum of squares, yung total, ano? Tapos divided by 10. So ganyan lamang yung SSB. So for example, ito yung mga sum of squares, di ba? Yan, 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 yan. So square nyo lamang yan, tapos divided by 6 lahat, no? So for example, SSB, medyo maliit lang yung space, ano? So SSB is 3,320 squared divided by 6 plus 3,416 squared divided by 6. And so on, hanggang ma-add nyo yung ilan to? 5, ano? 3,663 squared divided by 6 plus 2,791 squared divided by 6 plus this one, 3,664, ano? Squared divided by 6. Tapos minus this one, 16,854 okay, squared divided by 30. So you're supposed to get something like SSB is equal to 85,356.5, ano? Mga ganyan yung SSB. So after calculating SST and SSB, to get SSE, you just simply ano get the difference between SST and SSB. Ano? So SSE is equal to SST minus SSB or SSA. Ano? So ito yung sum of squares of error. So this is just simply yung total, yung sagot natin dito kanina, 209,376.8 minus yung 85,356. So you're supposed to get SSE to be equal to, or SSW, that's the same. And the SS, ano pala yan? Yes, SSW should be equal to ano, 124,000, ano? I'm supposed to get 124,020. So pag meron na kayo nitong tatlong values, SSE, SST, at saka SSB, ilagay nyo na lang sa ANOVA table ano, to calculate the F calculated. So ito yung ating ANOVA table ano. So as you can see, ito yung ating this is our SSA. No, ito yung ating SSA. Ito yung SSE natin na na-calculate. Tapos itong 296 is the SST ano. So actually itong dalawa yung mahalaga ano, yung SSA at saka SSE. So tapos okay, so we just divide this ito kasi 'di ba yung ito yung degrees of freedom niya, 'di ba? You have 5. 'Di ba? This is ito 5 k minus 1. This one, this is k minus 1. So we have 5 minus 1 equals to 4, ano? Tapos ito namang 25 kasi 'di ba you have this is simply n minus k or ba, you have 30 data, tapos minus number of treatment, minus 5, so you have 25. No? Tapos you simply divide this, 8536 divided by 4. So ito yun, ano? 21,339. This is SSA divided by 4 or divided by the degrees of freedom. Tapos ito naman, 124,000. Tama, 124,020 divided by 25. You're supposed to get 4,960. Ano? Tapos you simply divide this to, and then you're going to get the F calculated. Ano? 21,339 divided by 4,960. You're supposed to get 4.30. No? So, ito na yung ating F calculated. Okay? So, next. Next, punta kayo dun sa ano, no? Tingnan niyo yung F value. So, yung F table. So, ang ating B1 ay 4. Tapos ang B2 natin ay N minus K, no? That's 25. Tapos if you're going to look at the F table, you're supposed to get F is equals to 2.76. So if you're going to compare the two, you will find that di ba kasi ganito 'yun ano? Ganyan yung F graph, ano? So ito yung critical. So ang critical natin ay 2.76. Okay? So yung 4.3 andun siya sa critical. So therefore there is significant difference, ano? You need to reject the ano no? You need to reject the null hypothesis and accept the alternative hypothesis. So ibig sabihin there are significant difference between the treatments, ano, between the values of the treatment. So if you're going to take a look at the values of the treatment, so makikita niyo naman talaga ano, yung number 3 data is relatively higher dun sa pinakamababa. Alam mo, pinakamababa, ito puro 400, ano? So this is significantly, most probably these two are significantly different, di ba? Pero yun nga yung disadvantage ng ANOVA. Ano, you cannot tell whether, halimbawa ito, magkalapit sila. You cannot tell whether this is significant. Yung extreme lang, ano, yung extreme lang, yung, halimbawa itong dalawa, may significant difference. Kung minsan naman kasi sa mga studies, ang kailangan nyo lang makita is kung may significant difference. Ano? So, yun naman yung kanyang application. So, I hope, you can do the ANOVA calculation on the final exam on the module 3 major assessment. Good luck.